Hi guys, I'm here to do a little video on freehand sketching. So what we're going to do, I'm going to go through this slideshow with you, talk through it. I'm also going to play a couple of videos. I'm going to talk through the videos and explain what I've done, and hopefully what you can do as a result of that is pause the videos and work at your own pace and try a few things out. What I want you to do is just try some freehand sketching. I want you to hopefully build on those skills and also like you to have a little bit of fun with it as well. So let's have a look at what we're going to do. So I want you to basically start using a pencil, paper. That's all you need today. You're going to build your confidence drawing shapes in freehand. So it's going to be squares, ovals, squiggly lines, just to get your hand moving on that paper. Improve your graphical communication skills and to understand how drawing and combining basic shapes you can create amazing designs or illustrations. So in the videos you're going to see, it starts off with just ovals, arcs, little shapes, and building on those to create different designs or creations. Hopefully you're going to apply those skills to an idea that I'm going to show you, or you can come up with one of your own. However you do it is up to you. I don't expect you to do every one of these videos, but if you're enjoying it, then do as many as you like. Outcome is then that you've practiced and improved your freehand drawing technique, and you've tried at least one of the examples on the slideshow, like I've just said. You developed and improved your drawing skills, and also you've had a go at doing something that you might not have done or would have done before. So it's pushing yourself a little bit. What we're looking for is when we come back in September, fingers crossed, you can, if you're asked to do some designs, you can rattle them out really quickly to a really good standard. So sketching is really important when you're designing, and being able to put ideas down quickly is really, really important. So let's have a look what I'm going to ask you to do. This first task is where you're just going to have a go at some basic lines and shapes. Now, it might look a bit daft, it might look a bit squiggly and not particularly neat, but that's not the objective here. We're not looking for super neatness. We're looking for you to get that fingers, those fingers, that hand off the paper, getting that hand moving freely. A lot of times, especially when you are younger, you tend to keep your hand and your part of your arm on the paper or near the paper, and it makes your drawings quite small and fiddly. So we're hoping by just lifting your hand slightly and just moving your hand around, and even what you'll see in this video now is moving the paper around, you'll be able to create the images of the shapes a lot easier. So here we go. Oh, sorry, just go back. So here's some lines. All I'm doing is the hands off the page. Look what I'm doing now, I'm moving the paper around. So my hand's not actually moving anywhere, my hand is staying there, just off the paper, but it's enabling me to just draw some straight lines really easily. As a result of that, I can draw some shapes now. So I'm just going to do some shapes. Okay, so it's just the basic ones. So it's a square, triangle, and a parallelogram. So again, moving the paper around, making my hand nice and free, making it so I can confidently draw those shapes that I need to. And again, this is just practice. I do this all the time. Before I do any designing or any drawings, I always get a scrap bit of paper and I just get my hand flowing, get my hand moving, so that I can actually create these images. Okay, so next one I'm going to do is just some curves. Okay, we need to do curves. Most designs, most illustrations always have to have curves in there. So just being able to do that with your hand, it's something that some of you may never have tried before. So just give this a go. It's nothing complicated, it's nothing difficult. It's just getting your hand to move so that you can actually start drawing with a bit more freedom. The last bit I'm going to do on this page are just some ovals. So using ovals, a lot of the drawings that I'm going to show you in a moment do include ovals. So I'd suggest that you do have a go at doing these. Just moving the paper around, working quickly. Notice that I am working quickly, and the quicker you work, the cleaner the line tends to be. So before you move on to any others, if you want to, you can pause the video now if you wish to do so and have a go at doing that. The other videos that you're going to see, you can just watch as you go along and attempt the ones you want to. But I want everybody to have a go at doing that, just grabbing a bit of paper and having a go at doing some freehand lines and shapes. Okay, I'm going to go on to the next slide. So the next one is sketching with shapes. So this is just like a little character, a dog or a bear, and this one is done using seven ovals. That's all it's all it needs. So the basic structure of it is 7 ovals. So let's have a quick look at it. So here we go. So here's a dog. I say dog, it could be dog or a bear. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this could be any other creature if you wanted to. If you wanted to give it longer ears and some little buck tooth at the front, you've got your rabbit. You draw it a bit smaller, you got yourself a mouse. Any of those kind of things. If you look and you watch videos, older videos of proper Disney cartoon characters, you'll see a lot of sketching in this style where they're using the ovals underneath and then they draw over the top, Mickey Mouse being a fine example of that. So, as well as watching these videos, if you want to go onto YouTube and have a look at other videos that show how you can draw these different characters or draw these different things, please have a go. The whole point of this is getting you interested, getting you into something. So if you do enjoy this, then please don't just stick to my videos. See what else is on there. There's loads and loads of really good things on the internet. Again, as this is a video that's rolling along, if you want to pause it and go back and have a look at how I did that, then that's absolutely fine. You work at your pace, you do what you need to do. Let's have a look at the next video, another little character. This is a frog. So again, this is predominantly with the arcs again, or the ovals. And again, using these shapes, it helps you to position things, so you know where to put things. Okay, so I've drawn the head to start with, little body, and then the legs out the side. And then all I do from there is I go over the top of them. What you're going to see in a lot of these videos is the fact that I'm not going to expand at the moment on these. I'm going to keep these pictures. So I've got them stored away, and I'm hoping to save them so I can do a bit of colouring or a bit of rendering, a bit of shading with you in a future tutorial. So we'll have a go at rendering. For your assignment, if you're wanting to hand these in with colour, then that's absolutely fine. I'm just thinking a little bit further down the line if we do have the opportunity to do a few more tutorials. I hope so, because I'm quite actually, after the initial fear, quite enjoying this now. So just talking through what I've done, explaining how I've done it. Okay, so there you can see I'm just drawing the features over the top. Now watch where I've got the big circle there, but I don't use that big circle because I think it's going to look a bit wrong. So I just lower that down, and I didn't need it, but it was there just as a guide. So there's my little frog. I can expand from that now as well as adding the colour. Before I did that, I could draw him on a log. I can have a little bit of a background. You know, the choice is up to you. Once you've actually done a drawing, you expand from there. Another thing that we could discuss is if you did these drawings as line drawings and you used a bit of tracer paper to go over the top, you can scan these into the computer and even use Photoshop for your colouring. So there's so many different things you can do once you've done a really nice basic sketch. Okay, I'm going to go on to the next slide. Talking about YouTube videos, there's so many YouTube videos of Bart Simpson, so why don't you have a look online for how you can do some of the Simpsons characters? They're really, really easy once you get used to it and you start using these shapes. For the sake of this though, I thought I'd just have a little draw, because if you haven't noticed, I love drawing, and I'm always doing little things like this. So let's have a look at this one. The actual artist for Bart Simpson said he's actually made up of 2 tin cans. So if we have a look at the cylinders that I draw, you will notice it. So I'm just going to press play so you can actually see that now. Okay, so there's one tin can there, the big one, and then his neck is a smaller tin can that pops out there. And then once you've got that basic shape, you know where to put the other things. So there we go. Put that in, mouth around there. Eyes, and then obviously we're going to use some line at the top for Bart's trademark hairdo, and a little bit that goes above the eye. So again, only took a couple of minutes to do, but again, it comes through practice. I've not just picked the pen up and done this for the first time. I've probably done that little picture about 100 times. Practice does make perfect, especially with sketching, and it's how you develop, it's how you get better, and it's how you improve all the time. So again, if this is one thing that you wanted to have a go at, then please do have a go, by all means. Let's have a look at the other things that I've got in store for you. Now, robot. Now, this one I would say to you is a little bit trickier, a little bit harder. Let's have a look at what I've done. I wouldn't go straight onto this one. I'd start one of the early ones first, like the dog or the frog. This one I would say is verging on moving into a proper 3D drawing. I'll steer away from this. And again, with drawing this robot, this is not something that I've just said, oh, I'm just going to draw a robot, and I've never done it before. I've looked at magazines and comics, watched cartoons, films, and I try and copy styles. And there's nothing wrong with that. Copying styles is a good way of actually starting to develop your own. Your design style could be a mixture of artists or designers or companies even. So being design technology, it's one of the main things that you can do. I'm not saying rip them off, but it's getting inspiration from somewhere else first. Nothing just appears from nowhere. Something is always inspired by something else, whether it be by a specific thing like nature or even by other artists. So please look what other people do. Mimic it. Copy it. Then add your own style to it. So if you've ever seen Futurama before, if you're looking at the arms and the legs on this one, they look very similar to the robot in Futurama. But obviously that's where I got my inspiration. But this is just drawn randomly. Again, using the shapes, drawn quickly. This is not a perfect drawing. I know it's not a perfect drawing. I'm not looking for perfection. I'm looking to improve my skills and improve myself and try something new and not worry about getting it wrong. When you're doing these rough, quick sketches, getting the idea down is the most important thing. You can start refining, start improving as you go along. So I could quite easily get this, get a bit of tracing paper over the top, get myself a fine liner and iron out all those little bits that I don't like and make improvements. Then I could actually start colouring it, shading it, using markers, pencils, or even going into, like I said before, going on to a piece of software like Photoshop, Adobe Illustrator, to add colours and make it look like a professional piece of work. There's the eyes. Again, not perfect, but not a bad effort. Have a go. It's one of those ones where I would say, don't do it first, like I've just said earlier on, but if you wanted to, want to try your luck, see how you get on. Very interesting. Okay, so that's that one. I'm now going to show you a couple of different ones. Now, these ones are more product design based, because obviously we're talking about design technology. So if we're looking at a controller, video game controller, this one's an older school or old style one. But again, it can be easily created using the shapes. And again, this one, all these later ones, I would say don't attempt straight away. If you wanted to do this as an extension task, then that's absolutely fine. But again, we're moving into the three-dimensional business here. It's going to look a little bit more 3D. If you wanted to do a games controller as one of to design your own and using these styles, then why not try just a bird's eye view or from above view instead of just doing it from the side? I'm just showing you how you can, with practice, get ideas down really quickly. And I did say earlier on, if you're a designer and you can get ideas down quickly, it's a really, really, really good skill to have. Very desirable in terms of being able to show potential customers very quickly what they might be looking for and what they might need, as well as having a proper visual idea instead of just something that's floating around in your head because you could easily forget. So if you can get the ideas down, then that's a real bonus. That's why a lot of designers do tend to walk around with a sketchbook, might be just a small pocketbook, just so that they can either make notes or get a quick drawing down so that when they do get home, they can actually refine it and improve it. Okay, so like I say, that one wasn't perfect either, but it's just getting that idea down on paper quickly. Let's have a look at the last main one that I've got for you. So this one's a torch. Again, it's down the product design route. So I just thought I'd have a go at just drawing a torch using the ovals again. So let's have a look at how that comes on. So the first thing I do, I draw a line down the middle. Now, the only reason I'm doing that is so that I've got my guide. So I know that if I draw my oval towards the middle, I've got a proper guide and I can keep everything centralised. So what you'll see now is I can link it all up using my line drawing skills again. There you go. To create the outline of my torch. Now, what you'll see as I'm working along here, this is just a little bit for where the wrist strap's going to go. But I'm just going to start adding the features now. Once you've got that main shape, it's really easy to start adding features, including curves. Okay, so what you'll see in a moment, as I start drawing, I'm going to put a little switch on it, of course, because obviously a torch needs a switch to turn it on and off. But I'm going to draw some little grooves in here. Now, the reason for drawing the grooves is something called ergonomics, which you might have heard of. But that's how your hand interacts with a product. So these are little ridges where your fingers can sit or fit, and it just means that you've got a better grip. So there's a little design element that I've put onto this drawing. All I'm doing now is just using my free handy skills to do another squiggly bit, and that squiggly bit is going to be just a wrist strap there. Just put a bit of shading on there to show how it looks. Okay, so again, don't have to do this one. This one is a bit trickier, but you can have a go by all means. Okay, I'm going to show you one more thing now, because some of you, when you do hand in this assignment, might want to add colour, or might want to put some shading on, just finish it off and make it look professional. So I'm just going to show you a little step by step of how I would do one of my characters a little bit further, or take it on a little bit further. So, sketching with shapes, adding the detail. So I always start, like I've just showed you in the last few slides, this little character here that I'm drawing, just using the art circles. You can see all the circles, how I want to position my character. There's his hands there, so I'm positioning the hands where I want them to be, and then what I can do from there is then build on top. So I go a little bit deeper with a pencil. Like I said in the earlier slide, at this stage here, what I could do, once I've gone over that area, get another bit of paper or light onto a light box, or get some tracing paper, and then go over the refined bit with a fine liner, which will then enable me to add more features, like the shading and the extra little bits, like his little belt or his little backpack thing that he's got here. And then you can start shading that, colouring it with pens, pencils, markers, whatever you wanted to use. Or, like I said, if you had a tracing paper and you could scan it in and do some computer work, if that was something that interested you. Maybe that's something else that I could discuss or give a tutorial on at a later date. So here's the last little picture. I've just put a little bit more shading. So the idea is then, guys, is do the page of just the squiggles, get your freehand working, and then attempt any of these. It doesn't matter which one you do, and then we want you to hand that in. So I've set this for all of year 7, but other teachers are going to be obviously releasing it to you. All the teachers in design technology are very, very capable with illustration and drawing. So if you've got any questions or you need any advice as you go along, then they will be more than happy to help you with that. Also on that note, in terms of handing it in, please put it in, because it's going to be set as an assignment, and your teachers will be more than capable of giving you some feedback as well. So the main thing I want you to get out of this is that you enjoy it, that you engage, and just try something new, see how you get on. I think you might impress yourself, and I'm looking forward to seeing some of your efforts in the near future. So hope to see you all soon. All the best, and I will see you hopefully in the near future. Goodbye.